So, hi there everyone, welcome back to another episode of the LookSee. My name's Leon, I'm the one looking after you. And in this video, we're having a look at Eternal Edge, which I've been provided by the developers to have a look at. Now, I'll be honest, I've had a few issues getting into this because it looks like, from what I can see from the discussions, when there was a change from the alpha to the beta branch, it didn't update the start desktop icon, so you kept getting errors. But we've got around it, and we're into it. So let's see what this is all about. It. There we go. So we want to start demo. I think I will go with keyboard for this. Hopefully it'll be the fairly sensible keyboard option. Oh no, hang on. Give me a control option finally. But right, that's that, that makes sense. Okay. Yeah, I mean, it's all right giving instructions for the controller only in the chat, in the instructions, but you've got to make sure. Some people don't like playing with controllers, and some people, you know, as I found there, my controller won't work with this game. So you should actually include instructions for both. So that's how you do that. Right. So your wife's sleeping, or must be having a coma type thing. Four sources to find. Small chest there. Right, inventory's I. Okay, so you can do crafting as well. We want to go east. Oh, there's a sword. Take that. Okay, no, we won't save game. Huh. Always good to have a spare. Oh, chest. I was quite lucky. Right, we're going east. I take it the skull means there's bad guys.
Wait up.
Yes, it did. Okay. Okay. Now there's some what looks like plants there. Future quest. Right, so we've got the bit we need for that quest. We're going to be going that way eventually, but let's go back and complete this quest. What's that? Ah, so you actually hit it. It up now. Not one of those plants. Nope, you actually have to hit it. Strange. Okay. Travel well over there, okay. So I take it that's what that thing on the map is there. Oh, some more plants. Maybe we'll find what all this is eventually. Who knows? Right, that's there. That looks like a different type of plant. Where are we going for the quest? Up there, I think. Of death. Essence of light, okay. Got a few different essences. Wasn't there this thing that put one into attack. That's it. No, I think it's that one. That's cruel, putting so many chests on the map like that. Well, there's one nearby. I Right, see, he's a bad guy. Okay, that didn't go so well. Does it revive us, or do we have to start again? It seems to take us back to there. Still two of them there. Why is that not? We got some little. Right, so I think we got some armor there. Ah, right, so we've got to click in to actually. Improve it or not? No idea. But I want these guys. Yes. Oh, wrong button. Now that says to me I've got another weapon. Eh! There's a baddie, I can't get through it. That's just cruel. Okay, what we got over there? Can't get there. Yeah. There's one there, but we can't get to it. Right, can we just run up the side of a mountain? So I'm assuming this is where... There's more wood round here. Activate this well. Right. Who are you? Astra. Yeah. Right, so you've leveled up. Now, does that mean we can do something? So it's not that, obviously. Right. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Quest. I don't know if leveling up just boosts us or what. I assume it must be just that. But yeah, I like the idea of this game. I really do. I like the look of it. I think it could be a lot of fun. I think there needs to be... There seems to be this thing at the moment where there's been a lot of words going into games. And that, I'll be honest, does put me off. You know, the title, what your missions need to be shorter, snappier, so that people can just keep playing. With so much reading, you just get to the point where you just flick through it. As you saw, as I was getting through that, I was flicking through them so quickly. I'll be honest, it was probably making me miss some of the bits I need to know. And I think a lot of people do that, and therefore the game gets, you get to the point where you go, well, I don't know what I was doing, and you switch off. And this is not just about this game, it's about lots of games I've played recently. So that's one thing I would suggest to any developers watching this, is try and make your narrative as tight as possible, so that people can stay in the game. Yeah, I mean, as I said, visually, I think it looks amazing. A lot of fun. I think this could be absolutely an amazing game, but it's still beta, and I hope I'll come back and visit this in the future. We might even do a series with it once the game gets nearer to its actual release time. Let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you've enjoyed it though and do want to see more, please do hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new, or if you haven't already done so, leave your comments below. But until next time, bye bye for now.